While we are publishing this video, almost more than 5 million persons around the world have been infected by the COVID-19, in which more than 2 million persons have been recovered successfully so far. Still, the complete information about COVID-19 is unknown, and research professionals were working harder to get the real underlying picture behind COVID-19. When it comes to COVID-19, there is more misinformation or rumor around the internet, which could possibly get you into depression. To avoid that issue, the information presented in this video is mainly collected from the authentic resources, which include Center for Disease Control and Prevention, United States, National Health Service, United Kingdom, World Health Organization, and other scientific studies published in authentic journals. I suggest you refer to these authentic sources for any doubts or information rather than looking after the unauthentic sources, which may not be accurate in most cases. Before we look into the content, remember the symptoms of COVID-19 is not common for all individuals, and it used to vary from person to person based on various factors, which include age, pre-existing medical conditions, lifestyle, immune system, and more. In any case, the good strategy to keep you safe is to consult with medical practitioners and seek professional medical advice all the time. Based on the recent research, the CDC claims that the people infected by COVID-19 experienced symptoms within 4 to 5 days from the exposure. Recently, the CDC published COVID-19 prevalence rates, as per which around 83% to 99% people with COVID-19 experienced fever, 59% to 82% people with COVID-19 experienced cough, 44% to 70% people with COVID-19 had a symptom of fatigue, which is the state of being physically and mentally tired. 40% to 84% of people with COVID-19 had a symptom of aneroxia, which is loss of appetite for food. 31% to 40% of people with COVID-19 had a symptom of shortness of breath. 28% to 33% of people with COVID-19 had a symptom of sputum production, which is a mixture of saliva and mucus coughed up from the respiratory tract. 11% to 35% of people with COVID-19 had a symptom of muscle pain. In detail, a study of 1,099 hospitalized patients identified that the fever was present in only 44% of patients. However, later the fever developed in almost 89% of the patients. Only less than 10% of the cases reported common symptoms like headache, confusion, running nose, sore throat, hemoptysis, vomiting, and diarrhea. Few of the patients also reported loss of sense of smell. One study found that as many as 13% of RT-PCR confirmed cases in children were asymptomatic, meaning that they haven't had any symptoms during the detection of COVID-19. In general, you remember the below symptoms and respond immediately if you experienced any of the below symptoms: cough, shortness of breath or difficulty breathing, fever, chills, muscle pain, sore throat, loss of taste or smell, nausea, which is feeling of sickness with an inclination to vomit, diarrhea and vomiting, breathing trouble, persistent pain or pressure in the chest, confusion, inability to wake or stay awake, bluish lips or face. In general, irrespective of above symptoms, if you feel any symptom that is extreme, it is always important to contact medical care for support. Alternatively, in United Kingdom, National Health Service has listed 3 main symptoms of COVID-19, which include high temperature. This means you feel hot to touch on your chest or back. Continuous cough. This means coughing a lot for more than an hour, or 3 or more coughing episodes in 24 hours. If you usually have a cough, it may be worse than usual. Loss or change to your sense of smell or taste. Most people with COVID-19 have any one of the above 3 symptoms. To be more accurate, the study of almost 44,000 persons with COVID-19 from China showed that the severity of this disease range from mild to critical. Tentatively, 81% of people tested positive for COVID-19 had only mild to moderate symptoms, including mild pneumonia, which was caused by infection of one or both lungs. 14% of people tested positive had severe illness, which include experiencing shortness of breath, hypoxia, which means difficulty in amount of oxygen reaching the tissues, etc. Only 5% of people tested positive are kept under critical stages, in which they experienced respiratory failure, multi-organ system dysfunction and more. According to WHO, the patients with mild illness recovers within 2 weeks. However, the recovery of patients in severe and critical stages takes up to 6 weeks. Hope you all like this video. Share this video to your friends and do subscribe for more videos.